Everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to Let's Play Dead Space, Chapter 7, Into the Void. Killing the Leviathan who is contaminating both food storage and the air quality of the Ishimura. We are on the mining deck to, I guess, attach a distress beacon to an asteroid. Now we're gonna launch into space. I give them points for ingenuity, but that sounds like a half-baked, flimsy-ass plan. Before I go self-stop, let's finish collecting. I'm pretty sure when we left off last time, I had kinda emptied my inventory, but I might be wrong about that. Either way, we are gonna collect up. They're giving me a store right next to a bench. That makes me think that some pretty heavy shit's gonna go down. Although, to be fair, I don't remember this chapter too terribly well. I remember the bit when we get to the asteroid later on. That's about it, though. And no, I didn't empty my inventory that well. After the Leviathan, I thought I did. Also, I feel like I'm doing the Enslaved Odyssey to the West thing again, pronouncing Leviathan weirdly. Gotta kick the habit. So I took a long break between recording the last episode and this one. I've been taking too many of those, so there is inevitably gonna be some rust that I'm gonna have to shake off. How did I not notice this? Alright, cool. So I have 11 nodes. And I hear the whispering again. So, let's see, on the line gun, I wanna get my next mine upgrade to make the mine a little bit more effective. I think. Rig, yeah, why not? I mean, I have a whole bunch of nodes left over, might as well get one HP upgrade. Taking hits here and there. Range, sure, why not? I don't want duration, but I'll tell you where, if I can, so I have a node left over. Energy is the big thing that I want for stasis, though. I'm not sure if I'm gonna upgrade the duration even further. I've been pretty okay with the duration as is. Okay, so we have mining access key and find the beacon. Yeah, so until that happens, we can't get down to the actual mining deck, so we have to get... Well, no, this is the mining deck. That's just the mining floor. We're gonna have a whole bunch of shit coming in through the roof. Somebody already made it in. Hey. This is a really cramped space where the FOV can get in the way. Okay. I'm not sure if that's a good place for that. Yeah, it's a little bit too small at quarters to be throwing the mine around willy-nilly. Any more? I hear that gurgling, but... Oh, I know what that is. Hey there! That may look like a slasher, but if you look real carefully, he's way, way beefier than a normal slasher. That was, in fact, the hunter from a few chapters ago. Whoops. Now we cryo-froze and launched, someplace else, and now we know where he picked up. Hey, fuckers! Shit! I wasn't ready for this. Okay, let's make sure we can't bring that guy back. Whoa, what happened? No thank you. Let's see. I don't know if that mine's gonna reach, so I'm trying to sever the appendage. The little tongue. That seemed to do the trick. What happened to the other infector? Like, I see the explosive sac. Did an exploder come in here? And just... Why would that happen, though? What the fuck? Man, that room is weird. Okay, so it's like a half-alive guardian. Or half-formed, maybe. Yeah, that room is super weird. I guess a couple of exploders must have spawned in, and one of them took the other exploder out along with one of the infectors. What? I'm not gonna question it. That's pretty helpful. Okay. Give a little bit of an RE4 ski lift moment, kinda. Oh, you. Oh, man, I'm gonna really chop that one up to rust. I should try to let the movement of the lift do the aiming for me here. Damn. They make this bad SM explosion effect when the pod explodes. Like, you sever the tentacle and then the pod eventually dies on its own. And they make this party splurging noise. It makes me think that one spawned. And then I turn my attention that way, and one is actually spawned on the opposite platform. I did it again. I noticed a bunch of these explosive canisters too, so I should probably grab a few. Set that down carefully. Even for being kind of rusty, that wasn't bad. I have to shake that off though. I really do. Hey, Nicole's sighting. We've kind of heard from her on audio logs and we've seen her flash up briefly. But this is, I think, the first time we've spotted her in person, so Nicole and Isaac back together last. I'm really feeling like I don't know if I'm gonna leave these or take these with me. Okay, I remember this section. I should have taken the other one, but I think two will probably be fine. So, in the sequence, we have to protect Nicole while she opens up the door behind us. Again, another RE4 parallel. It's kind of like a less shitty version of protecting Ashley in the water room in the castle. But you can see she can die here, it will game over you. You can see her rig on her back, indicating how much health she has left. I don't know where that mine went. It wasn't nowhere, apparently. I should be a little bit more economical with that line rack ammo. Oh, no, no you don't. Ow. Tiny waste of stasis, but not too bad. She still hasn't taken a hit. You can shoot her. I'm not sure if she'll die immediately, but she will take damage. L keeps like Maria in Silent Hill 2 where if you shoot her she just fucking dies. Ah, L you. Okay. I used a little bit too much ammo. Rushing to take that out so I can get back over to you, but not bad. Not sure if she even got hit, actually. Can't quite tell. Looks like she took a little scrape. We really have to dig under those bodies from across the gap to get those items. Hey, Isaac. Hey, I want you to sit here for a while. Yes. Yeah, don't worry. I think you've got the beacon, so head to the mining bay and attach it to the asteroid. I've been running trajectory calculations, and if we launch soon, there's a good chance the asteroid can resist distance to begin transmitting. Still in time, Hammond. Because, Kate, I can't imagine she's still alive. So if you noticed, we picked up the level 4 suit schematic. Wait, no, did... Oh, shit, did I just push that down the abyss? Fuck. Ah, because I'm pretty sure I have to fight those guardian pods on the way back, too. So I want to be using that. Do I have workers I have to deal with on the ride back too? I think I do. Yeah. Someone gave me a hint about kind of just shooting them center mass, almost. Like towards their spines instead of going for the three tentacles. It's not a bad idea. I've been doing it whenever I have the plasma cutter out, but... I feel like just shooting the tentacles is a little bit more reliable, though. Ah, shit getting in my way. Okay, I'm gonna do that. I don't think I got all of it there. Fuck. Yeah. Oh, that's gonna be no good. Oh, hey, buddy. Hey, buddies. Let's... I was thinking about doing the mine, but I was worried that it might land too close to me and explode in my face. Isaac's got his on. Level 3 suit. Pretty safe. Feeling secure. Oh! Was not watching out for that. Almost. I reacted a bit too fast. Alright, so we went straight to the bottom floor. Deck C is mining, Deck B is processing, so... I think the next thing we have to do is head up to processing. I think technically it wanted us to go to processing first, but whatever. Do I have... shit. I don't have anything nearby. I need a little bit of everything right now. Hey, Jacob and Elizabeth! They're still going strong. I love this theater of the mind journey that they take you on through all your logs. They're really helpful narrative devices. Jacob and Elizabeth's journey are useful in that sense to characterize Isaac because their paths are kind of similar to his. And it makes you believe survivors are really scarce, but they do exist. And Isaac isn't this super special hero for persevering. They add a lot of touches like that to keep Isaac feeling ordinary and vulnerable in the context of the narrative. Whether or not you feel that as a player depends on how much you struggle in the game. Like, if you blow through everything without sweat, it's super easy, then Isaac fails as a vulnerable everyman type of character. If you just scrape by, though, and you are continuously barely making it out in situations, then mission accomplished in terms of characterization. It's a difficulty as narrative vehicle kind of thing. I'm running in circles right now because I'm just trying to see if I've missed anything along the president's path because I don't intend to fight him. Or her? Yeah, he's gonna come from around the corner, isn't he? Yeah, so we'll just do the stupid circle thing. Okay, right down that hole. Yeah, no intention of wasting any ammo whatsoever fighting that pregnant. I just have to remember that I left it there when I come back this way later. Otherwise, I'm gonna get blindsided and sucker punched. I could still use a stasis refill. I'm not sure if there are any in this chapter, or at least in the early part. There has to be some later. Mining deck log, Cruise G. The situation here has just got a lot worse. The gravity failure came as we were collating asteroids, and one broke free of the grav beam. It collided with a wall, killing two crew and split into chunks. They're free floating in the processing room, and we can't restore gravity to get the master key until they're cleared. We can really use some engineering help. That is actually just spelling out what our objective here in processing is. We have to incinerate the chunks of asteroid that broke free. I believe that's out this way. There's a zero G wall here. I see some stuff I can collect from the other side. Come on, I want that line rack ammo. I see it. I can fucking see it. Oh, I want another inventory space. I'll drop that there and come back for it in a minute then. Okay, so there are 4 fragments of asteroid. We will use that to incinerate. Nope, didn't need to get the body. Oh, see, yeah! Value. Okay, now I hear it's triggered some enemies. Maybe I can dunk this third one? Nope, stop. Goddamn offer him. Like, Kendra literally describes it as dunking. Yep, they love throwing leapers at you in 0G sections. They love the leapers here, and workers. That worked out super well. No, I don't have stasis. I was using the asteroid fragment as a shield against the lurker. I am bunched up too, but I don't have any stasis left. I can use a stasis pack, but I don't feel safe going in my inventory right now. God, that would've been beautiful. It would've really saved me a headache here, though, too, though. Okay. Let's just go for it. It's not 3 bullets either way. 3 shots to the center mass, or 3 to where the, 3 to the tentacles directly. Doesn't actually save me all that much ammo. It's a little bit easier to hit than there, I guess. Okay, cool. Freed up a little bit of inventory space. I'm sure that will spawn something I can't pick up. That's... what is that? Pulse? Oh, stasis back. I'm mad that I'm still getting pulse round ammo. cannot grab. Zero-G stuff is super disorienting. Dead Space 2 handles this way better. Okay. I need to go across the way to restore the gravity. To that panel over there. Okay, so, we're about halfway done the chapter. That's it for now. Thanks for watching, everyone. Take it easy. Have a good one.